monument for First World War. We died in England, you for England live. And we're here at Ecclesfield Church, which is a Grade 1 listed building in north of Sheffield, and it's, well, they think they were a church on here since Anglo Saxon times, but this particular church was built in the 1500. Obviously it started in 1400s and finished in 1500. And it's the burial ground of Dr. Scott, I believe his name was, Admiral Nelson's personal doctor, and in whom's arms he died on his flagship. So we might even come across his grave or his tomb or whatever he's buried in. So let's go for a walk around in it. Look at that old keyway. That's a door, isn't it? Right, we'll walk around this way. Over these old graves. We'll be put down as a path. Let's have a look at this, see if we can work out what this is. Or not the hour. Something for we. No, not the hour. Oh, no. Some people think it's morbid walking on graveyards, but I happen to find it relaxing, and it's good to look at mortality of people throughout years, get into perspective of your own mortality. And, of course, you get to see some great heritage. No wonder this is listed. Yeah, let's just have a look from the yard first. Then we'll come back to church. Wow, it's extended right up here. Graveyard. In them times was quite good. So blessed are the dead which die in the Lord. Wherefore, something one another. Comfort one another. Therefore, comfort one another. 1904, that one, mate. Let's have a look around the church itself. I don't think we're going to get in it, but the Queen's Green Canopy for Platinum Jubilee 2022. And obviously a year of the death. No. Which room? Parkins, an old name from Sheffield. I've seen a few Parkins. Unusual. Edward Bellows. Not far away from here is a place called Bellows Road. But I think that's the bellows for grinding, polishing knife and forks. I wonder where this tomb is then. Dr. Scott's. See, they used to put bolts underneath the church at one time. Look how ornate this is. I've seen that. Cast on grates. So oops. Right. Now they're all documented, these graves. So if you wanted to look these up to find out who's in here, you can get PDF documents. Of who's actually buried here and probably where, because some of these graves you can't even tell who's. You can't even tell from inscriptions who's here anymore. See, these are clays and died in 1800, it looks like that. Look at the old trough. Old trough. That, if I'm not mistaken, is where somebody's been buried in that. Like, it looks like a Roman. Romans used to get buried in things like that. I'm sure they did. And have them lead lined. I may have been mistaken. But that's definitely a burial, being made for a burial, unless it cracked or something and then they couldn't use it for that, so I decided. But isn't that interesting? And then used for a hopper, for water. Yeah, pretty cool. Butterfly. Right, from here, I think going to take the drone up. I'll see if I can get in first, see if it's open. then I'll put drone up.
Interested in
oldest
book?
Oldest grave?
Yeah.
Yeah, what is it?
Well, I walk around here every day. It's the oldest one I've found. There's one round corner that's, you know, like one of these things. That's obviously a medieval one, because there's no writing on that one.
Yeah.
But the oldest laid down stone is this one I've found. Jeremiah Lord, 16. Now I don't know whether 1600s when he was born, and when he died he was 1676. I don't know how they wrote it in them days.
Yeah, because this one's 1726, I think, isn't it?
But 1676, that's the oldest one I've found him up to now. But you can tell it's freehand, isn't it? How they found it. But Jeremiah Lord.
But these what are laid down flat, these all will be the old ones, won't they?
Yeah, like, And there's like one of them square ones here, just round.
Do you know where he was buried, that? Dr. Scott? The Nelson's doctor.
I've heard about that.
He's supposed to be in one of these tombs, or crypts or whatever. I know they used to put crypts underneath church.
Right.
So I don't know if it's there or if it's one of these, like, raised crypts.
There is some Scots, Dixon Scots.
Yeah.
On the back wall. As you go around the corner, there's some, this big white one.
Yeah, I've seen Dixon's up on that.
Dixon's,
on that top.
Yeah, there's some Dixon
look,
Scott.
Thing, it, yeah.
That's going to do it.
Yeah.
But that's definitely the oldest one I've looked.
I've just noticed, do you know where the upper is? Have you seen the water pipe that comes out? Now that's obviously been repurposed, but that's been for a body, hasn't it?
I would have thought so, yeah.
But if you look at shape of it, that's not dissimilar to what Romans used to bury their dead.
Right.
So maybe that's been fetched here, or been, you know what I mean?
Mm.
But that I don't know, I'm not saying it's Roman, but that's how they used to do it. And then line them with lead.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Do you know?
It's been here a long time, because I remember playing hide and seek and lane in that.
Yeah.
When I was a kid.
I was just wondering if it had been made for a burial, but then it cracked or something.
Yeah.
And then they just thought, well, we'll repurpose it for this.
Yeah,
you know,
maybe.
All time and effort was gone into it.
Yeah.
But yeah, I'm just filming it for my channel, because it's there's not many. It's grade one listed, this, isn't it?
I think so. Yeah.
So it's really old.
Yeah, they've just. I've lived here all my life, like, and I walk around here every day, because I've got that shop across the road.
Yeah.
But yeah, they just recently had a roof done, that were a fortune.
I was just gonna see if it were open, but I don't think it's. It don't look open.
It has been open. You just missed it. Last weekend it were open there. You could go up to bells and everything.
Oh, wow.
You can climb right up steps, right up to the top. I went a couple of years back and they had like a... You missed it last weekend. Same weekend at Queensfield.
Yeah.
Yeah, it were all open. You could go in it all on. They were just blocked.
Oh, I'll keep an eye out for it and go in and see if I can film it with it being so old.
Blokes, I took there, shows you all bells and stuff like that. Fascinating up there.
Yeah.
Exactly, as I was saying, what's all these like wooden stakes on bells, and when I would put a thing on there and do a silent practice.
Oh, yeah.
Lights up downstairs.
Yeah.
So
what do you call them? It's gone. But I've lived on Flower Estate all my life. And I've been past it, and I've never walked round it, so I thought, I want to make a thing of going round. So I film a lot of these old churches.
Yeah.
So. Anyway, thanks for letting me know about that.
Yeah, that's the oldest one I've found anyway.
1676. I'm going to presume that's his birth and that's his death.
Yeah, that's what I thought. It sounds about right, didn't it? I thought, why would they
Although,
be 1600?
It says the 24th day of December. Oh, yeah, that's when it would have died, innit?
Yeah.
So, yeah, 16 to... Yeah. Yeah, that's... Well, I'm I'm not gonna go looking now to try to beat that. I'll assume that you know.
One round corner is a little bit after that.
Yeah.
That's one of them square things, but it has got a plaque on the side. But that's.
Yeah, I mean, it's somewhat where they wore off, aren't they?
Yeah, yeah.
And you'd never know unless you look through records.
You have to look for like freehand carving, don't you? There's a couple with freehand carving, but they're not as obvious as that.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Anyway, thanks for that. Uh-huh. Cheers, pal. Thanks. That was nice of him. Hiya. Wonder why that carving seems to come on into this one. Strange. Well, I can't see it being open, but let's just have a look. There, somewhere. Nope, motion sensors, and it's shut. So, I'm going to leave it here. And I'm going to put my drone up to show you what it looks like from above. Cheers.